I'm Catherine Anaya, and welcome to My Home Group TV. In this My Community episode, meet Eddie Escobedo, who is a My Home Group real estate agent and a Filipino martial arts master. He knows the dangers realtors often face, and that's why he's created a three-part program to help you protect yourself.
Usually when I do an open house, I'll do like a Facebook Live just to give them a taste of, you know, what the house looks like and, you know, come on out and tour the house. I'll be here until, you know, 2 o'clock. So gave those details on a Facebook Live post, posted it. And about 20 minutes later, I had someone come to the door, which I thought was just, you know, a person coming to see the open house.
My Home Group real estate agent Anna Tovar is talking about the day a man showed up with no interest in buying a home.
His response was like, no, I saw your Facebook, you know, live feed and I just wanted to come and talk to you. And that was when my gut was telling me, walk outside.
She did and immediately called her son.
You need to come. You need to come and just be with me at this open house. I don't feel safe. I don't know this man, but yet he claims to know me and he doesn't want to buy a house, so he's here for another reason. From there, once he knew there was someone with me, he then would say, oh, okay, well, I'll just talk to you later. Looks like you're busy, and walked out.
Anna's experience is something many agents fear or face.
For me, I would say as a real estate agent, that was probably the most terrifying feeling, to be like, wow, something could happen.
It could be any situation where they're alone with the client that they don't know. Mm-hmm. It could be in the car. It could be walking from your office to the car, from your car to the open house. It could be anywhere.
That's why Eddie Escobedo, a martial artist and realtor, created an hour and a half self-defense course specifically geared to real estate agents.
Do you find that there's more of a concern now than ever before, or has this always been a concern?
So interesting you asked. This has been happening for a very long time. However, no one really talks about it. It's not really in the media. But because it just recently happened in the media, people are now starting to say, I want to take your class.
Eddie's course is broken into three parts. The first is all about awareness.
So being aware of your surroundings, I mean, I think is the most important. Listening to your gut instinct, not being focused on your cell phone, you know.
Give me an example of where you wouldn't be aware of your surroundings, like what could happen. For example, on the video, you show somebody walking in as the lead. Mm-hmm. So give me an example of how people can visualize what they shouldn't do.
So let's say you're on your cell phone, you're walking to your car in a garage, or even in a parking lot at night, and you're texting or you're on Instagram. There could be someone hiding behind your car. There could be someone hiding behind someone else's car. So if you're just assessing the situation and looking for a possible threat, that's the first way to keep yourself out of danger. If that does occur, you already knew, okay, well, there's another car there, there's people there, I can run there. There's a broken bottle on the ground, I can use that. There's a rock, I can use that to defend myself. Maybe you put your keys in your hand a certain way. Maybe you pull your cell phone out ready to call 911. Mm-hmm. You know, so awareness can help you get out of the situation and even help yourself.
The second part involves technique or hand-to-hand combat.
So we're gonna teach you how to defend yourself with someone that has a weapon, someone that doesn't have a weapon, and even if you have a weapon or not. So let's say you're sitting in an open house and someone walks in and they try to attack you with a blade. We're gonna teach you some techniques to help you defend yourself without getting as hurt as if you didn't know anything at all.
Eddie likes to emphasize this is equally important for men as it is women.
And a lot of men that I talk to that say they don't wanna do it is because they conceal a weapon. Mm-hmm. But the interesting thing is, if you're concealed, you gotta be able to know that there's a threat and be able to defend yourself before you get to your weapon, because that doesn't always happen.
Mm-hmm. The final part of Eddie's course involves EDC bags, or everyday carry bags, he says that agents should have with them, especially when they're showing homes.
And so what should then people have? Because you say they should have certain things in their bags to protect themselves. Mm-hmm. What would that include?
So it could be everyday carry. It could be your bag, it could be your pocket, it could be a purse. Something simple as a flashlight. You know, say power gets turned off, or, you know, someone shuts power off, you have a flashlight, obviously a cell phone, maybe a power bank to charge your phone in case, you know, you're getting low and you need to call police. If you have something like that in your bag, you can still help yourself get out of the situation.
You want to be professional, but at the same time, you want to know that You know, is this person really here to see a home, or are they here to do harm?
Awareness and instinct is what Anna says helped her ward off a potentially harmful situation.
My first encounter where I felt scared, where my gut was telling me, like, something can happen, like, trust. And I've always trusted in my gut and my feeling that's saying, like, okay, red flag, there's something wrong, something doesn't feel right, so make sure you're protecting yourself.
How often do you recommend that people do a course like this to stay on top of it? I mean, is it a little like CPR where you should, you know, re-educate yourself on mm-hmm. a regular basis?
So this seminar really is just giving you awareness and give you some techniques, but that being said, you should practice as often as you can mm-hmm. because it's not a one-time and you're an expert. It's like playing baseball or basketball. You should practice every day. A lot of agents that I've spoken with have said because of this, they now feel comfortable sitting in open house, mm-hmm. where before they wouldn't. Mm-hmm. So they feel empowered. They feel a lot more confident.
If you would like more information on Eddie's self-defense program for realtors, you can contact him on social media at My Tactical Agent. Remember, you can subscribe to My Home Group TV at mhgtv.com, and you can watch all of our episodes on our My Home Group YouTube channel. Remember to subscribe, comment, and like while you're there. I'm Catherine Anaya. Thanks for watching My Home Group TV. I'll see you next time.